Well, you can't say that. What can be better than Visual Studio Code? It's free, appealing for devs, and if you're a beginner, a single tutorial is enough to start off. Then the rest of the story depends on the programming language. But if you're a dedicated C or C++ programmer, I think you have a better option. And that is codeblocks. Don't worry, codeblocks is also free and even an open source IDE, which stands for Integrated Development Environment. Okay, how you can get it, how to install it, and obviously, why should you consider this as your everyday development tool? I'll explain all this, but before that, hit the intro editor. Codeblocks is a free and open source C, C++, and Fortran IDE developed by the Codeblocks team. The good thing is, it's written in C++. Makes sense, cause you're mostly gonna write C and C++ codes with this, right? If you're talking about Fortran, well, it's up to you what you're going to do with that 66 years old programming language. However, you can use this IDE just as an editor for other programming languages like Python or HTML. And there are static coloring for lots of programming languages, so it can be useful to edit other languages. It supports lots of compilers for C and C++ language. But with the installation package, you can only get the GCC one. Other compilers like Intel or Clang should be installed on your computer separately. Then change the compiler from the compiler settings. But the thing is, for a C or C++ dev or a beginner, it's a great tool. The download size is around 150 megabytes. And takes half of a gigabyte of your computer's disk space, including the GCC compiler, where you have to install everything separately for VS Code. Codeblocks has got everything for you within one package. Considering that Codeblocks is a full-fledged IDE, where VS Code is just built to edit lots of programming language in one package. Also, Codeblocks is not hard to use. Its GUI is pretty much user-friendly, and you have a lot of professional tools and plugins to use. However, let's see how you can get this and install this. You can get Codeblocks from the link in the description below. And here's a short, you know, like a clip, a short clip for the instruction.
Okay, so here we are on the installation part, so you have to double click it. Then click next, then of course I agree. And now you got five options. First, full. It will install everything what it got. Sorry. And then standard. The standard will just install the things that it needed to run, you know, the Codeblocks program smoothly and well. And then the minimal, just the minimum things that you need to run Codeblocks. And editor means you can only edit codes, you can just compile or build them like an complete IDE. And custom means that if you want to, you know, like install your own things, then it's good. But I'll go for full, but the space requirements will change depending on your installation method or whatever, full, standard, minimal, editor, or custom. But I'll go for full, and if you're a beginner, I recommend you to go for full. And I'm also a beginner. So here you can just browse it wherever you want to go there, but But I have already installed Codeblocks, so yeah, if you didn't, just click here. But I won't, because I've already installed Codeblocks. Okay, now let's take a short trip in the world of code blocks. Now let's dive in. What the? Why was that Windows Media? Okay, let's forget that. Wait, let's forget not responding programs. Well, if you want to make a new program from completely scratch, you can just click for empty file. And now, and if you start to put something like blah. Okay, I'm just not. But I have already created a program, which is open. Well, here's the program. This name is demonstration C. It's just a simple C program, which actually determines the root of a perfect square number. If you want to run a code, it's just simply click run. But just, you know, like if you already built it, but if you didn't build it, just click build. Okay. And I didn't edit this code properly because I didn't complete the function here, and it just, and I, one thing I really want like about the code blocks is the build messages. The build message actually just to try to guess that what was I trying to write. Like it's saying that did you mean scanf? Yes, of course. And let me play scanf. Yes. And oh, one more cool thing is that this got code completion, similar to IntelliSense in Visual Studio Code. Well, let me demonstrate another auto code completion example. Well, let me type standard I, oh oops, standard I, oh, standard IO dot H. Well, it just auto completes it. And if you just simply want to build and run together, here you go, click here. Just now just type anything like 16 or 31. And that's how you just build this and run this program. But there are a lot of more cool things that, like the editor. I just customized the color of this editor by going to editor and simply going to stylus highlighting. Here the foreground would be black. If you, oops, set the foreground color black, the all text will be like black. Foreground white. And if you, then I hope you guessed what's the background about. The background is just the whole background color. And if you want to just customize the other colors, like the other Stanex colors, just like the brackets the keywords or the strings. If you can, I don't know if you can customize the brackets here. I don't actually know the proper method to do that, but still, it's a real cool thing to just customize and create your own Stanex color code. Well, that's all. But if you want to just customize the margin color here, oh, I just accidentally added a breakpoint, I think. And here you can also just, wrong setting. You can just change the compiler here, but I'm not changing. I just have one compiler. Well, this is just a few basics, but one cool thing that if you just don't like to build something from completely empty file, you can just select a project template, and there are lots of project templates like the GLUT project, ARM, AVR, Arduino, DirectX. But one thing about DirectX, which actually I don't like, developers, please update this. if you are thinking that why the DirectX icon is old, that's why. Like, look at them, like the DirectX 8, who just want to make the DirectX 8 application in 2023? That's actually weird, but please, developers, update this thing. I don't know when you'll just release a stable update, but please fix this. And let me save this. And one thing I accidentally done is just okay. That was almost everything. Almost, like, not almost, not even almost. It's just in tip of the iceberg. And as far as I think, it should run now properly. Okay, this was just a tip of the iceberg. But one more thing is that you can, I already showed you this. You can also set build targets, or you can also, if you want to just, you know, reduce the pain of just making a class every time, you can just use this GUI class creator from this programming, which is really cool. I can just say any nonsense, or just the name, or you can also say I can also build a header file, like lots of classic C++ stuff in here, which I really like. But one more thing that I already said, that there are a lot of plugins pre-installed in this packet, full installer package. But if you let me show you one fun plugin, BYO Games Collection. If you are just bored, if you're just bored to code a lot of lines, just play this to just reduce your boredom. Well, that's fun. Oh, oops. Well, this is okay. If you want some more exploration, this is just out of the scope of this video. Okay. I hope I just said this line in a right grammatical form, I think. But still, this was just some basics of this program, and I think that's the end of this video. But if I missed something really important, please please write down that important thing in the comments. I'll be happy to discuss about that later. And that's all. And please don't be mad at my grammar skills. I'm really bad at that.
And that's the end of this video. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. However, YouTube don't care if you dislike this video anyways. But be sure to subscribe to this channel and also visit my website, because good guys like you are always welcome to our community. And until the next video, bye-bye.